to all of you. I am Jim Kumar. Today, I want to teach you the first chapter of Honeycomb. The name of the first chapter is Three Questions. Once upon a time, there was a king. One day he thought three questions, and he realized that if he would know the answer of these questions, then he would never fail in his life. Do you know what were those questions? Those questions were: first is, what is the right time to begin something? And second is, which people should he listen to? And third is, what is the most important thing for him to do? So the king sent his messenger to his kingdom to announce that if anyone would answer all these questions, then he would be rewarded by him. Next day, all wise men came to the king's court and answered of the first question. Some of them answered that the king prepared a timetable and follow it strictly. But somebody answered that the king should make a council of wise men so that according to time, the member of the council could advise him to begin any work. Some of them answered that the king should go to the magician. Thus, for second question, somebody answered that the king should listen to the test. But some of them answered that the king should listen to his soldiers. Thus, for the third question, some of them answered that the most important thing of the king is fighting. But somebody answered that no, the most important thing for the king to do is a religious worship. Thus, a lot of wise men answered differently of this question. But the king did not satisfy. The king was not satisfied. So, the king decided to meet a hermit. The hermit lived in a forest. The hermit was known as a wise man all over the king's area. When the king reached the hermit was digging his fields in front of his hut. The king greeted him, and the hermit also greeted the king. The king saw that the hermit was old. So the king felt pity on looking the hermit. So the king took the spark from the hermit and began to dig his field. After some time, the king said to the hermit, "I have come here to know the answer of my three questions." But the hermit did not speak anything, and the hermit wanted to take the spark from the king. The king did not give the spark and began to dig. After 1 hour, one time who? That time, the hermit said to the king, someone is coming to ask us by money. Both turned. They saw that a man was coming. That was holding his stomach because the blood of his stomach was growing. The king dressed his stomach. After some time, when the wounded man felt some goodness, then he said to the king, please give me a glass of water to drink. The king provided him a fresh glass of water. After that, in the night, the king had to stay there. The king, the hermit, the wounded man had slept on that night. Next day, in the morning, the wounded man said to the king, excuse me. The king wondered, what are you saying? I don't know you. The wounded man said to the king, you don't know me, but I know you. You don't know me, but I know you. I am your old enemy. You have hanged my brother and seized my property. I knew that you went to the hermit alone, so I was waiting to return you and I wanted to kill you in midway. But when you did not return, then I went to you to kill. I wanted to kill you, but you saved my life. So I promise you that if I would live, then I would serve you as a faithful servant. After that, the king wanted to recover his coat from there. Then he thought that once more he should ask the answer of his question to the hermit. So once more the king asked the hermit. Then the hermit said to the king, you have already found the answer of your questions. After hearing this, the king wondered, how can you say that I have found the answer of my questions already? Then the hermit began to make understand the king. He said to the king that if you would not stay yesterday here, then your enemy could kill you. So in the project, if you stay with me and dig my fields, that is the right time to begin something. For the second portion, we made understand him that if you would not stay with me, then you would not dress the wounded man. And the wounded man, it means your enemy, would kill you. So, if anyone put you in a particular moment, then you should listen him. And next, for the third question, the hermit said him that if you would not bless the learned man, then that did not become your friend. And that hermit said to the king, we should do good work to anyone because we have sent in this world to do good work for anyone. Thus, the chapter ends. And now I want to say you that this is the inspired story for you, for us, or for all. If we grow the sense of this story, it means if we grow the answer of this question,